At Arbor Insulation Solutions, we get a lot of questions about spray foam and what really is involved. And one of the things that we're concerned with is making sure you do it right and do it to code. So typically, when you go up to encapsulate your attic with spray foam and you have an HVAC system up there or storage, the code is going to require you to have typically an ignition barrier. An ignition barrier is basically a 15-minute fire-rated treatment paint or material that's just going to give you or the service tech enough time to get out of there in case of a fire. Doesn't sound like that big of a deal, really. And what some of the spray foam guys will tell you is that you don't really need it unless you go to sell the house. And I'll just tell you, that's not necessarily true. What really you got to be concerned with is if there is a tragedy and something does happen with your house, and the inspector comes out from the insurance company and he finds out that the spray foam was installed and you were incorrectly or misinformed about whether or not you should do the ignition barrier. Basically, there could be two possibilities here. Your payment for your claim is delayed while they do an inspection, or your payment is denied because you didn't do it to code. We just want to make sure you guys are aware of what could happen when you're misinformed by some of these other insulation companies or spray foam guys that tell you you don't have to do it or you can put it off. I would advise you against it. Hope this helps clear up a little bit about the ignition barrier, thermal barrier question. If you have any other questions or need any additional assistance, don't hesitate to give us a call. We're here to help.